Hello there. I'm Kenneth, a resident clinician at Bristol Park Hospital, and I'm here to talk about diabetes mellitus. It's a disease that affects so many people. It can come in silently, damage your organs, and most people are picked by chance. So, what is this diabetes mellitus?
It is a disease that is caused by
a certain organ in your body, in your abdomen called the pancreas, gets damaged and is unable to produce a hormone called insulin that is involved in sugar control. There are two types of diabetes. There is type 1 and there is type 2. So, what do we mean by type 1? Type 1, we mean that this organ of yours that is in the abdomen completely cannot produce insulin. And usually it's a juvenile disease. Juvenile, we mean
for young people, though it can still occur
in old age or even mid-age, like 40s, 50s. So, type 2, diabetes. This type 2 diabetes means that that organ we are calling the pancreas is either secreting a defective type of insulin, or it is secreting insulin that is not meeting the body's demands. And this one, usually most people are picked by chance. When you visit our hospitals, we ask for that sugar test, and it occurs in either your body fights your organ, the pancreas, damaging those, they are called cells that will produce that insulin. It can also occur through genetics, things that fall in your family. Okay, now I want us to talk about the complications of diabetes, and we'll talk about the ones that are dangerous and the ones that occur slowly. So, not using so much of medical jargon, the worst complications of diabetes are the ones that usually patients are brought to hospital either unconscious or semi-conscious. There are two, you don't have to bother knowing them. We abbreviate them as DKA, the other one is HHS. I want us to look at complications of diabetes in your body from the head to the toe. So, to the head, strokes can occur, because diabetes is associated with high blood pressure. Your eyes can get something we call cataracts. There is a lens in your eye that will get things deposited there, whitish in color, so you lose your vision slowly. It can also damage the part in your eye behind that usually receives the images that you see and sends that to the brain. So, to the chest, you can get heart complications. You can get lung complications. To your abdomen, you organs that are easily affected by these sugars being either low or high, the first one to suffer is the kidney. We've seen many people, and here at Bristol Park, we have dialysis sessions for many patients, and sad enough, some would have been picked earlier before their kidneys fail just because of diabetes. And usually a simple test is just a prick of the finger, and that will show you whether the blood sugar is high or low. So to your lower or to the legs, people get wounds that do not heal. Some get something we call gangrene, that like your toes start rotting away. Usually these patients end up in the ward, spend a lot of money, sell their land or so many other things, whereas they could have been picked very early and this could have been avoided. Here at Bristol Park, we have several simple tests that we do, even in the outpatient department. You don't have to come fearing that you must go to the ward. One, a simple test, a random sugar prick to your finger, within seconds, that is picked. We can do a fasting blood sugar. That means you fasted for more than 6 hours. Then we see the ranges. You don't have to bother much knowing them. When you come to our facility, we can avail those explanations to you. There's one test we call HbA1c. Don't bother much. When you come, we'll explain to you more. But this test shows your blood sugar control, if you are diabetic or if you've never been picked, shows the sugar control in the last 3 months. There's another one, a simple test, a urine test. Just get a bottle, put some urine taken to the lab, and we pick. Then we have another one which is called OGTT. Don't bother much, but that is, we give you 75 grams of pure glucose, then we repeat the tests. How do we manage diabetes mellitus? Here at our facility, we usually want to have a wholesome care. In that, we want these three things that have to be, if someone is having diabetes. We need to put you on drugs, diet, control. We have our nutritionists. They take you through what you're supposed to be eating, what you're not supposed to be eating. Lifestyle changes, we talk to you. If you do take a lot of junk food, red meat, choma, alcohol, we talk to you on how to safely handle your life in terms of this disease, which actually takes so many people and causes so much sorrow in families. Diabetes has had a lot of health burden to many families. I know you know someone who has had diabetes. Probably you know someone who had complications of diabetes that could have been avoided. The first organ to suffer mainly is the kidney. And when we have dialysis session in a hospital, it feels like, how was this missed? This patient maybe came from somewhere very far in the village there, but they never knew they had diabetes. And now their kidneys have failed. There are three simple things that I would want you, my listener, to pick. One, excessive thirst. Like you find someone taking 5 liters of water in one sitting. Two, excessive hunger. Find someone takes a plate, feels hungry again and again and again. Then the third one is excessive going to the short call or urination. Those are three pointers to diabetes. And this is mainly in type 2. Because when type 1, usually, in most cases, patients are brought unconscious. So there are other vague symptoms that one may ignore or maybe take it as normal because you live with it every day. One of them is you feel like your toes are numb, your fingers are numb, there is tingling like pricks of a pin. Could be diabetes. Come have a blood check that takes only 3 seconds at most. A prick to your finger, we see your sugar. Others are excessive hunger associated with irritability. Someone is always annoyed. Someone may feel anxious. Maybe the sugars are high. You never know. You didn't know you had diabetes. So, all in all, we want to say that the burden of diabetes does not only lie with us healthcare workers. You, as my listener, you still have a chance and a room to do some impact. Maybe you have someone you know has had these symptoms, ignores them. Maybe they talk to you. Tell them to come and we do simple checks. All in all, we still have others that may involve imaging, that is x-rays, heard of CT scans, depending on what someone has. Like there's a CT scan we check of the legs and see how your blood is flowing. Because in diabetes, that one is usually compromised, and we can pick that. Ever since someone amputated just because they had diabetes, the complications were not picked, that can be avoided. We still have high imaging, MRI, we all do that. But all in all, we engage you from the word go. Once you come to us, we talk to you privately, of course. We listen to you, we examine you, we send you to lab for all those tests that are necessary. We send you for imaging, which is indicated. We call in our nutritionist to see you, to talk to you. We call our physiotherapist if you have problems with walking, joints, issues related to diabetes. All that can be done in one setting. So feel free to come. Feel free to talk to someone about diabetes. We have empowered you. Remember the three things: excessive hunger, excessive thirst, excessive going to the short call. Thank you.